Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Keroack, President and CEO of Baystate Health. Last year, the name of George Floyd was added to an already too long list of people of color killed at the hands of police. His murder brought new urgency and depth to conversations around race and racism, and it forced white Americans to confront realities that African Americans have known about for many years. It advanced my own thinking about the pace of Baystate Health's efforts around diversity, equity, and inclusion, and our journey toward being an organization where all feel that their individual backgrounds and perspectives are recognized and respected. In the past, DEI programs focused on individual learning and development. They help learners confront implicit bias and expand their understanding and appreciation of different backgrounds, viewpoints, and cultures. While this work remains important, there's now a growing awareness of how discriminatory practices can become embedded over many years into both organizations and societies, something called structural racism. I want to use this month's blog to share our ongoing efforts to identify and eliminate structural racism at Baystate Health and the communities we serve. The Baystate Health DEI program has focused for the last decade on supporting individuals of diverse backgrounds across the organization through our business resource groups, raising awareness of DEI issues through educational programs, and celebrating the varied cultures and lifestyles that make up our health system. These efforts have been highly effective at opening the minds of many employees toward different lived experiences and perspectives. But they've not achieved all of the goals I feel are important for the organization, particularly when it comes to diversity in hiring and advancement. Why are we not moving faster despite all this good effort? When I look at all the conflict and oppression that's occurred across the world and throughout history based on race, ethnicity, religion, class, and beliefs, it's hard not to conclude that we as human beings are biased by our very nature in favor of people who look, think, and act like us, and against those who do not. Centuries ago, when we lived in small tribes, these instincts may have served some good purpose, but they're certainly not helpful today in a multiracial and multi-ethnic organization like Baystate Health. Biases routinely cause hurt and misunderstanding between people of different backgrounds. But when they motivate the actions of those with greater power, whether consciously or unconsciously, they can have direct effects on health as well. We see this today in Western Massachusetts, where growing up in neighborhoods with limited opportunities shortens the lifespan of people of color by as much as 10 years. And for an organization like Baystate Health, whose mission is health, the root causes of these health disparities cannot be ignored. Baystate Health has tackled structural issues related to race and ethnicity with some notable successes in several areas over the years. Our Board of Trustees has changed the way it selects new members, prioritizing diversity, and it's resulted in our growing from 1 to 6 Black and Latinx trustees and from 3 to 8 women on a board of 20. The change in the conversation at board meetings has been remarkable. The board has embarked on its own training in DEI, and they're as anxious as I am to see progress across the organization. This year, Baystate has set numerical targets to increase the percentage of Black and Latinx providers, nurses, and leaders from their current percentages in the mid-teens, and to reduce turnover among all employees of color. The health system also has seen great effects from its work to reduce racial and ethnic disparities in Springfield through its work on social determinants of health. This includes some long-standing programs such as the Baystate Academy Charter School and the Baystate Springfield Educational Partnership, which have allowed hundreds of diverse students from challenged backgrounds to pursue healthcare careers and, we hope, form part of our workforce of the future. Baystate has invested in 413 Cares, an online community database that identifies resources to address social needs in our highest risk neighborhoods. This year, we also have launched the Family Prosperity Innovation Community under the leadership of Dr. Frank Robinson, our VP of Public Health. Led by Baystate Health and the Western Mass Economic Development Council, this community brings together the large employers of the area to commit to measurable progress in purchasing supplies and equipment from diverse vendors, diverse hiring and advancement, community investment, and advocacy. Baystate Health began intensive and targeted intervention on the social determinants of health 4 years ago for 44,000 patients in Springfield's highest risk neighborhoods through our Be Healthy partnership, a Medicaid accountable care organization for patients at our three community health centers and Caring Health in partnership with Health New England. Attending to issues of housing insecurity, food insecurity, transportation, mental health, legal services, and other social supports has had a direct and demonstrable effect on the need for healthcare services and improve the overall health of this vulnerable group of patients. Knowing the social situations of these patients also led to much more rapid interventions to deal with COVID-19 and to encourage vaccine acceptance. But what about that look in the mirror for Baystate Health itself? It starts with accurate measurement, and the HR informatics team is launching a campaign to get accurate employee self-identification information into our new software program, Workday. This will also allow us to understand gaps in DEI when it comes to hiring, advancement, and turnover. A DEI dashboard is in the works that will guide the work of a multidisciplinary structural inclusion committee, led by Jennifer Faulkner, VP of Team Member Experience, Diversity and Inclusion, and Talent Management, as well as Patty Samra, VP of HR Operations. The Committee of 60 is taking a systematic look at policies and practices across the organization to see which ones have a differential impact based on race and ethnicity, understand why this happens, and to explore how to mitigate those effects. Their work has already led to a redesign of the language of the imagery of our health careers pages. Further structural work to advance diversity has also been accomplished, including developing policies for patients who discriminate against providers, developing policies for employee gender transition, offering English as a second language to help build language skills and confidence, and a structured welcome program for international nurses. The work is still early, but the group has brought great enthusiasm to the effort and they're learning a lot. To advance my own learning and to borrow practices from better performers, I've joined one national and one statewide DEI networking group. I've been surprised to learn how early most other organizations are in their journeys and how few have a clear roadmap for which policies and practices to focus on first. The Structural Inclusion Committee is continuing their explorations just the same, and in some ways they're drawing up that map for Baystate Health, which we'll certainly share with others. Beyond the work in structural inclusion, the DEI office will continue its foundational work on the Elevating Dignity curriculum for both employees and managers. This program was identified and implemented by Yemisi Olorantola-Coates, our former chief diversity officer, who recently left to take a job at WGBH in Boston. We're committed to keeping the momentum of this program going, and so while we begin our search for a new chief diversity officer, we've engaged the services of Waleska Lugo de Jesus, a local DEI expert who was the founding director of the Healy Racism Institute of Pioneer Valley. Waleska will help facilitate Elevating Dignity sessions and share her thoughts on how to make our DEI program stronger. Respecting the dignity of all is a core value at Baystate Health. Valuing how different perspectives strengthen the organization is a core competency. Lifting up our talent and unleashing our potential is a cultural pillar. And becoming a workplace of choice is a key strategy. All are advanced by our commitment to diversity, equity, and inclusion. In an environment where one's race or ethnicity may predict one's health, we cannot fulfill Baystate Health's mission without grappling with these important issues. And in a country where population trends indicate that we all will be members of a minority group in a few years, we will live longer and better lives as we make it our practice to understand more about each other and embrace the essential dignity of every individual.